Hello, I'm Sheila Thompson, Principal of Rosenberg and Parker of Canada. Public-private partnerships, P3s, and risk. Well, we all know that any construction project is risky, and that's no different with a P3 project. The construction risk still is there. But with a P3 model, the risk is allocated to the party that's best suited to manage and mitigate that risk. So we have construction risk, we have commercial risk. This is really important in a P3 model because the project actually has to be completed on time so that it's up and operating and running and can generate the revenue needed to start to pay down the debt caused by building the thing in the first place. So that's an extra part of risk that we see in a P3 model that we don't see in the regular construction industry. And there's also contractual risk. The P3 contracts are very complex and add in more elements of risk, perhaps, than you would see in a normal construction project. An example of this would be what we call liquidated damages, which would be a penalty for delay in completing the project. At Rosenberg and Parker, our vision is clear, and it's pure surety.